Rough Riders start divisional play with Corpus Christi here tonight, and we're joined by Rough Riders third baseman Alex Buchholz, who's gotten off to a great start to the season. Alex, it seems like all of your hits have gone for extra base hits. You've been so aggressive up there, making such great contact. You must be feeling like you're in a real good spot offensively with your swing.
Yeah, I feel pretty good. You know, we've been emphasizing be on the attack at all times, and when we're on offense, we're on offense. We're not going to have a defensive swing. I've just been getting a good pitch to hit early. It's been working so far, and just keep going with it. So,
it's noted in just taking a look at your numbers across the board. You haven't struck out. You've only walked once, so you haven't been going too deep into counts. So you've been really sticking to that method, tried and true.
I've been getting good pitches to hit. To be honest, pitchers in this level, they can spot up their pitches pretty well. They work in and out, and they make great pitches. You know, it's kind of tough to get walks here just because, you know, guys are so good here. So anytime you can get a fastball early in the count, you know, try to jump on it. It's been working good so far.
Talking to Boo and Jason Hart, they said that you were hitting the ball well in spring training as well. Have you just felt over the last month or so that, you know, your off-season preparation has really paid off? Did you do anything different coming into this year?
Well, I just came in with a little bit of a chip on my shoulder. I knew coming into spring training this year I had to work to make a job. And fortunately enough, I was lucky enough to do well. And now I'm here, and I just want to continue that success and do anything to help the team win.
This is your second season with the Rough Riders. You had your first Double-A experience last year, and you were kind of in a jack-of-all-trades sorts of role. You know, obviously, we had a regular third baseman in Olt, a regular second baseman in Garcia. Now you're getting your primary at-bats at third, and you're in the lineup almost every single day. The adjustment in level must be easier now that you've seen it before, and the fact that you're in there almost every day.
Yeah, you know, it's an honor to wear a uniform anytime. Anytime you're in the lineup, that's a good thing. Spring training's a reality check for a lot of guys, where you see a lot of friends go and you just realize it's really an honor and a privilege to wear a uniform. And anytime you're in the lineup, you want to make the best of that and have good success. So
is that a real motivating factor? As you said, giving you some perspective and seeing some friends go and wearing that uniform, does that make you perform a little bit better maybe?
Yeah, it adds a little motivation for sure. You can't be too hard on yourself in baseball just because you fail so much. If you let it affect you, it only gets worse. So you try to go out there with an open mind and have fun. But at the end of the day, you know that, you know, everybody's, you know, striving to be where you're at. And for you to be able to play every day, it's an honor. So.
We're here with Alex Buchholz. Incredible game on Tuesday night. You guys fall behind 7-0 in the second inning. You come back and score the next 14 and win by 7. What's going through that dugout when you find yourself down so big and early in the game?
Yeah, we seem to thrive off momentum for sure. We get a base hit there, here and there, and we just go from there, man. You know, we don't really have a lot of power on this team, but we have good line drive hitters, good gap-to-gap guys. And we put a lot of good swings together back-to-back. And, yeah, like you said, the other night was a good example of that. It just shows how this team never, you know, lets up. And, you know, we always feel like we're in the game no matter how much we're down. So,
first week of the season, offense was a little bit hit or miss. Remember all those close games against Northwest? And then as soon as you got home, the bats came to life. What kind of offense is this? Is it the one that scored 48 runs in 5 games, or is it the one in the first couple of games where scoring was difficult, or is it somewhere in between?
I think it's somewhere in between, just because, you know, baseball is so full of up and downs, and you're going to have games where you struggle and you're going to have games where you do well. It's just about being consistent and going day in and day out, you know, going through your routines and doing your thing. This team, you know, like I said, we thrive off momentum, so I don't see why we shouldn't continue our success.
On sort of a personal level for you, you've bounced around. You played for 3 different high A teams in 3 different leagues in 3 different years. Now this is the second straight season where you've been in Frisco. You're in the same spot. You're familiar with the opponents. You know the level of play. You know your teammates because you're still with the Rangers organization. Does that help at all?
Yeah, it definitely helps. Those years I was in high A too, the biggest thing is to stay healthy. It's a very long season. Anytime you can't stay healthy, you really can't improve. So my main objective is to stay healthy and, like I said, be consistent day in and day out. And to have the same faces around me, it's nice with my teammates here. And I really enjoy our company. So,
finally, off season I know was good for you for at least one reason. Ravens win the Super Bowl. How was that ride?
That was a very stressful ride, actually. I got invited to quite a bit of Super Bowl parties that I had to politely decline because I get too rowdy during the games, and I didn't want to upset people when I got upset because I was so nervous going into the game. But it turned out great, and I cannot wait for next year.
So did you watch in seclusion, or did you find a trusted group that could accept your rowdiness?
It was literally just me and my fiance, and we watched it, and I was so stressed out, and I told her, just give me one day where tolerate me, just tolerate my obnoxiousness, and she did, so it was great.
Well, lucky man, I guess. Congratulations on A, the Ravens, and B, more importantly for you, the tremendous start to the season. Thanks a lot for the time.
Okay, thank you.
That's Alex Buchholz, and we're back after this on the Frisco Rough Riders Baseball Network.